As of March 23rd of 2025, there are currently 48 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 2 more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes produced a major eruption this week, specifically Indonesia's Lewotobi volcano. Consisting of 3 volcanic cones, only the northern 2 of these have been active in historical time, with the northernmost Laki-Laki cone being the source of all 10 eruptions since 1939. This Laki-Laki cone produced a 30-minute-long subplenian eruption, which began with an explosion at 10:56 p.m. local time on March 20, 2025, sending a plume of ash to a height of 53,000 feet, or 16,154 meters, which ended up causing flight disruptions near Bali. Heavy ashfall from this explosion fell across a fairly sizable radius, and pyroclastic flows scorched as much as 21.6 square kilometers. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Italy, a new revelation was made regarding Campi Flegrei's damaging earthquake west of the major city of Naples, with this occurring alongside some people moving out of their flats due to specific structures being deemed unsafe due to the recent earthquake damage. Meanwhile, in Costa Rica, the Poas volcano is producing a new record level of small eruptions, and there is a legitimate possibility that eruptive activity could eventually progress into a true magmatic eruption or explosive eruption of a larger size. And in what is this week's top story, Hawaii's Kilauea volcano erupted again, producing its tallest lava fountains in 42 years, causing lava during the eruption to be intermittently visible from as far away as Hilo. While the U.S. Geological Survey noted that lava fountains peaked at around 700 feet in height during Kilauea's March 19th to 20th eruption, this merely represents sustained lava fountain heights. Intermittently, portions of a lava fountain would, for a few brief seconds, rise even higher, which is what I reached a peak lava fountain height figure of 1,039 feet or 316.7 meters. These lava fountains peaked in height from the southern of the 2 erupting vents at around 8:50 a.m. on March 20th. All of this occurred due to what is Kilauea's 14th eruptive episode since December 23rd of 2024 began, which has caused 13-hour to 8.5-day-long episodes of intense lava fountaining, followed by generally longer pauses in eruptive activity. Kilauea's 14th episode was its longest since January 18th, going for 29 hours in length. What started as intermittent weak lava flows became sustained weak lava fountaining, then both vents for a time erupted simultaneously until towering lava fountains were generated. While to me, it seems unlikely that lava fountains as tall will be generated during the next eruptive episode, the 15th episode of lava fountaining is expected to begin sometime between March 23rd and March 26th. In Italy, there was a development in regards to the earthquake the Campi Flegrei volcano produced on March 13th that was initially catalogued as a magnitude 4.4. This quake was somewhat unusual, specifically since it lasted twice as long as would be expected from an earthquake of similar magnitude, and due to the fact it caused up to 1.1 g's of ground motion to occur in one particular spot. Well, this quake, which caused damage to multiple structures and injured 11 people, was initially noted as a magnitude 4.4. A new estimate then increased its magnitude to a 4.6, although either estimate would mark this quake as the largest to strike the Campi Flegrei volcano in 440 years. Well, it turns out that this wasn't correct, and there was a specific reason why the earthquake lasted 5 seconds instead of the expected 2 to 3 seconds. Namely, it was 2 separate near simultaneous earthquakes. A magnitude 3.3 quake immediately triggered a magnitude 4.0 quake a second later, creating the misconception of a larger singular earthquake. Meanwhile, in Costa Rica, the Poas volcano has been erupting at an unusually high level for nearly a month now, with some days having more than 100 phreatic to phreatomagmatic eruptions occurring in a single day. Alongside this, volcanic tremor, sulfur dioxide emissions, and carbon dioxide emissions have remained high, occurring with an elevated rate of earthquakes. The most important piece of information revolves around the fact that recent ground uplift has been detected at the volcano, suggesting an influx of a larger batch of magma than is typical. These frequent low-intensity eruptions have slowly been draining Poas' main crater lake and its Laguna Caliente crater, and its acidic lake is now expected to completely dry out sometime during the first 3 weeks of April. While the following is purely speculation based on my opinion, if this occurs, I expect eruptions to become less frequent but larger in size. And then, we may even see some small-scale pyroclastic flows or even small bits of visible lava be ejected. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on March 22nd of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Ezek, for supporting this channel.